we're all using Outlook. Since a minimum of 10 years, that makes at least 2,200 workdays, meaning that for at least 2,200 mornings, you turned on your PC and you opened Outlook. Let's be conservative and assume that you sent 20 emails a day and set up 5 calendar appointments. I know the real numbers are probably higher, but that means that you've sent at least 40 to 50,000 emails and sent 10 to 15,000 calendar invitations. In this video, you'll learn 8 Outlook simple tricks that will save you time, enhance your productivity, and allow you to better collaborate with colleagues and customers. You'll be able to implement them immediately and take your productivity to the next level. Let's start with tip number one. Yes, definitely, we should meet again. How does your calendar look like this Friday, next Monday or Thursday? How many times do you find yourself in the situation where you are in a Zoom meeting or you receive an email where somebody asks you for your availability on specific days? Before knowing this tip, I was clicking on the first day and having a look at the calendar, then on the next day, and then on the next day. And it was hard to remember the 3 slots on each single day. Then I've learned this small tip that made me think, wow, it took me 10 years to find out. By clicking Control and then a specific day, you can select multiple dates and put them in a side-by-side view. For example, Friday, Monday, and Thursday. We're looking at the 15th, 18th, and 21st of October, all in the same view. Obviously, we can add dates, or if we are in a weekly view, we can see the whole week and then add a few other days. Did you know that Outlook has a built-in board where you can stick your memos? You'll find it by navigating to the bottom menu, clicking on the 3 dots, and then Notes. The board will open and you will be able to add your virtual post-it. You can position it in the board wherever you want. And you can assign it a color to categorize it. A quick way to write a new note, regardless of where you are in Outlook, is to type Control or Command if you're on Mac, plus Shift plus N. And let's categorize this note with a purple color. Often, when we receive an email, we want to schedule an appointment with the sender to discuss about the subject. An easy way to do that is to drag and drop the email on the calendar icon at the bottom menu. Outlook will automatically take the subject of the email and make it the title of the appointment. The content of the email will also be included in the appointment description. If you want to transform the appointment into a meeting, then you simply click on Invite Attendees. In a similar way, if you want to save the contact details of the sender, you simply drag and drop the email on the contacts icon. The name, email address, and any other information that is present in the email signature will be automatically generated by Outlook. This is another tip that changed my life. In Outlook terms, I mean. There are some emails that are more important than others, and that we often search for. For example, emails sent by our manager, or from a specific individual, or emails with an attachment, or simply we scroll down our inbox to look for the emails that we haven't opened yet. Instead of searching them every time, there is a much quicker way to do that. You can create custom search folders where you will always find the emails that are of interest to you. Go to Search Folders, right-click, and then New Search Folder. You can choose among many options, like unread email, mail flagged for follow-up, mail either unread or flagged for follow-up, important email, mail from and to specific people, or you can create a custom search folder with your specific criteria. To make it simple, let's create a folder for unread emails. Now all my emails will still be in the inbox, but if I want to have a look just to those that I haven't opened yet, then the unread mail search folder will show them to me without the need to look for them by scrolling down the inbox. There are cases where we write an email, but we would like it to be delivered at a later time. For example, if we want an announcement to go out exactly at the end of a meeting, or if we want to send out an email at a specific time, or if we want to write an email today, but send it out tomorrow when we are on holidays. To do that, let's create a new email and then go to File. Click on Properties, and then select Do Not Deliver Before. You can then insert the date and time when you want it to be delivered. Sometimes when we read an email, we need to have access to our calendar. Instead of opening the calendar, then clicking back on the email, then back to the calendar to check further details, and then back to the email? A more convenient way is to open the calendar in a new window. You can then have a side-by-side view that saves you time. And if you have an extra monitor, you can always have the calendar at sight. When we receive lots of emails, sometimes we just want to scroll down and have a quick look at them. By default, if we select an email and then quickly move to the next one, Outlook will mark it as red. If you want, you can change this. So for example, if you click one email after the other and just spend 2 to 3 seconds to have a look at the preview, then you can set the time to mark as red to 3 seconds. To do that, go to File, Options, Advanced, Reading Pane, and then select Mark items as red when viewed in the Reading Pane. You can then insert the desired value in seconds. There's a quick way to organize a voting via email. For example, you can ask your colleagues if they like the new logo or if they're up for some sport during the lunch break. This works well for simple answers as yes, no, or maybe. From the email, go to File, Properties, and then click on Use Voting Buttons. You can then choose between Approve, Reject, Yes, No, or Yes, No, Maybe. For simplicity, I'm sending the email out to myself. When the reader opens it, the little information icon asks to vote by clicking Vote in the Respond group above. Let's click on Vote, and then Yes. You can directly send the response or edit it before sending. The email sender will then receive notification about your vote. Did you like the tips? Then consider subscribing. You can now watch this next video to further enhance your productivity and communication skills. See you at the next Digital Tips.